In a landmark ruling, British retailers will be forbidden from forcing customers to pay surcharges when they use a credit card. And it's about time. Believe it or not, British consumers sometimes face very steep surcharges for just using a credit card, as much as 20% for purchases such as airfare. Now, this new rule, announced by the UK's Treasury Ministry, takes effect this January and will apply to government agencies and will help alleviate what many call rip-off charges. And those are not even my words, those are the words of Economic Secretary to the Treasury, Stephen Barclay. Now, this move will save British consumers hundreds of millions of dollars. The Treasury cited figures from 2010 that showed the total value of surcharges for debit and credit cards was estimated at £473 million, at least $700 million at that time. Meanwhile, here in the U.S., at least 11 states forbid retailers from adding surcharges to credit card transactions, this according to the National Council of State Legislatures. However, there are some loopholes. Many U.S. retailers are allowed to charge customers a surcharge for using plastic rather than cash, and even some states that outlaw surcharges, they allow stores to offer a discount for using cash. Loopholes. And then there's New York, which is one of the states with a surcharge ban, but back in March, the Supreme Court gave a partial victory to merchants who are challenging the law on the grounds that it could be seen as regulating free speech. Now, an appeals court had ruled that the law is a price regulation, but the case is returning to lower courts for further arguments and review. In other words, it's far from done. Loopholes. Back in 2012, credit card companies Visa and MasterCard, along with big banks such as JP Morgan Chase, Citibank, agreeing to pay some $6 billion to settle a lawsuit from retailers who said the companies had conspired to raise the fees they charge merchants. When that settlement took effect in 2013, it then cleared the way for retailers to add surcharges to credit card payments, something that's commonly covered by contract and not by state or federal law. So, maybe we here in the United States can learn something from the UK, but judging by how this appears to be contract regulated, not state or federal, and in the process of appeals here in the US, it doesn't look like we will have an easy time getting this done quite like the UK did. So congrats, UK consumers. You're about to save yourselves a lot of money, courtesy of your government. And if only, well, we here in the US, well, I won't go there. For Modern Wall Street, I'm James Swinney.